A very popular way to react to the pessimistic induction, which was developed by John Worrall in the late 1980s, and it has become extremely popular ever since, is well known as a structural realism. The key idea is that the structure of the world behind the appearance is knowable, but what is non-structured, the content, the entities that make up this structure, are not knowable. Historically, there have been two stripes of structuralism. One goes back to Bertrand Russell in the early 20th century, 1912 onwards. And the idea here is that there is an inferential route, a way to infer the structure of the unobservable causes from the structure of their effects, of their appearances. But there are very well-known problems with this position, which I won't discuss in this presentation. The other stripe is what I call the Maxwellian Worrallian stripe, because it goes back to an idea put forward by Grover Maxwell in the early 1960s, and it was developed in an independent way by John Worrall in the late 1980s. The idea here is that the world has excess structure over the appearances, but this excess structure can be captured hypothetico-deductively by the so-called Ramsey sentence of an empirically adequate theory. There is a problem there, and the problem is that on a Ramsey sentence account of theories, it turns out that an empirically adequate theory has to be true. The supposed excess content or excess structure of the world turns out to be illusory. There is another route to structuralism which goes back to Poincaré and Pierre Duhem. They both took mathematics to offer a framework which the empirical findings of science were embedded and organized. Faced with the problem of discontinuity in theory change, Poincaré argued that there is nonetheless some substantial continuity at the level of mathematical equations that represent empirical as well as theoretical relations. From this, he concluded that these retained mathematical equations, together with the retained empirical content, fully capture the objective content of scientific theories. By and large, he thought, the theoretical content of scientific theories is structural. If successful, a theory represents correctly the structure of the world. In the end, the structure of the world is revealed to us by structurally convergent scientific theories. Poincaré famously said, "Still, things themselves are not in what science can reach, as the naive dogmatists think, but only relations between things. Outside of these relations, there is no knowable reality." And he continued, "These equations express relations, and if the relations remain true, it is because the relations preserve the reality. They teach us, now as then, that there is such and such a relation between this thing and some other thing, only this thing. Something we currently call motion, we now call it electric current. But these appellations were only images substituted for the real objects with which nature will eternally hide from us. The true relations between these real objects are the only reality we can attain to, and their only condition is that the same relations exist between these objects as between the images which are forced to put in their place." John Worrall took up this position in the late 1880s, and he developed it in a more rigorous way. According to Worrall's position, the structural realist insists that it is a mistake to think that we can ever understand the nature of the basic furniture of the universe. In opposition to scientific realism, structural realism somehow restricts the cognitive content of scientific theories to their mathematical structure together with their empirical consequences. But in opposition to instrumentalism, structural realism suggests that the mathematical structure of a theory reflects the structure of the world, that is, real relations between things. Now, what is a key argument for structural realism of this kind of flavor? It's a version of the no miracles argument, which is a major argument for scientific realism. Successful predictions suggest that the theory is on the right track. The carried over mathematical structure of the theory correctly represents the structure of the world, and this best explains its predictive success. Now, if this argument is to lend any credence to structural realism, then it must be the case that the mathematical structure of the theory is somehow exclusively responsible for the predictive success of the theory. But this is not true. It's not true that the mathematical equations alone, devoid of their physical content, can give rise to any kinds of predictions. If structural realism is to employ this argument in order to claim that the retained mathematical equations reveal real relations in the world, then it should also admit that some physical content, not necessarily empirical and low level, but also theoretical, is retained. such an admission would undercut the claim that the predictive success vindicates only the mathematical structure of a theory, and similarly, it would undercut the epistemic dichotomy between the structure and the content of a physical theory.